Hello, welcome again. We are solving IIT JEE Physics. The topic is thermodynamic thermal properties of solids at kinetic energy. Question number 35 is a heat source. Question number 35 from year 2019 is a heat source at T is equal to 10^3 Kelvin is connected to another heat reservoir at T is equal to 10^2 Kelvin by a copper slab, which is 1 meter thick, given that the thermoconductivity of copper is 0.1 watt per Kelvin per meter. The energy flux through it in the steady state is options 190 watt per meter square, 2 120 watt per meter square, 3 60 watt per meter square, and 4 200 watt per meter square. So here the heat source is at T 10^3 Kelvin, and other temperature is directed to other reservoir of temperature 10^2 Kelvin to a copper slab. Okay. So as in between there is copper slab, so there will be heat transfer due to conduction only. Okay, so the heat transfer by conduction is given by K A T1 minus T2 by delta. Delta is thickness of the slab, and T1 and T2 are, T1 is this quantity and T2 is this quantity, 10^3 and 10^2 Kelvin respectively, and K is conductivity, that is 0.1, and as energy flux is required, so energy flux is your heat transfer by area. So so this is your K A T1 minus T2 by delta is the heat transfer, if it divided by area, then it is the energy flux. So energy flux is K T1 minus T2 by delta, and K is 0.1, and T1 is 10^3, and T2 is 10^2, and delta is 1 meter. So putting the value, will get energy flux, that is 90 watt per meter square. So answer is option 1. Next, question number 36. Half mole of an ideal monoatomic gas is heated at constant pressure of 1 atmosphere from 20 degrees Celsius to 90 degrees Celsius. The work done by the gas is close to gas constant R is equal to 8.31 joule per mole per degree Kelvin. Options are 1581 joule to 90, second option 291 joule, third option 146 joule, and 4373 joule. Okay. So half mole of an ideal temperature is varying from 20 degrees Celsius to 90 degrees Celsius, and as the process is constant pressure process, so in constant pressure process the work done is given by P V2 minus V1, and as pressure and from ideal gas equation P V2 will be equal to nRT2, and P V1 will be equal to nRT1. So putting the values, so it will be nRT2 minus T1. R is your universal gas constant, that is 8.31, and n is half mole, that is given, and temperature difference is 90 minus 20. So answer will be 291 joule. If you multiply this, answer will be 291 joule. Option 2 is the next. 2 kilogram of a monoatomic gas is at a pressure of 4 newton per meter square. Density of the gas is 8 kilogram per meter cube. What is the order of energy of the gas due to its thermal motion? Option 1 10^3 joule, 2 10^4 joule, 3 10^5 joule, 4 10^6 joule. So energy is just like work done. So if you multiply this P and V, because here the density is given, so you can convert into V. So volume will be your 2 by 2 kilogram mass into it, so volume will be 2 by 8. So pressure is 4 into 4, so it will be your there were four full energy videos of the doctor for four deep pantry option two. Because the TV returns the burden and gives some kind of energy. So this can cost four deep. So the answer is option two. Next, question number 13. An unknown metal of mass 192 gram heated to a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius was immersed into a brass chlorimeter of mass 128 gram containing 240 gram of water at temperature 8.4 degrees Celsius. Calculate the specific heat of the unknown metal if the water temperature stabilizes at 21.5 degrees Celsius. Specific heat of the brass is 394 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Celsius. So this unknown metal mass is 192 gram and was it to be brass chlorimeter. And if the temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, now it is immersed into a brass chlorimeter of mass 128 gram and containing water at 240 degrees Celsius. So initial energy, so initial energy should be equal to final energy that we will use here. So initial energy is MM, CP and PM and MC, CP, CC and MW, CPW, PW. So this is the mass of the metal. This is the MM is the mass of the metal, CPM is the mass of the, so specific heat of the metal and PM is the initial temperature. So this is the unknown metal, first unknown metal and specific heat is also unknown. Its mass is known, that is 192 grams. Initial temperature is known, so this MM, CPM and PM will give its energy. And second is your MCCPCTC. MCCPCTC. So it means it is energy of chlorimeter. So MC is mass of chlorimeter and CPC is your specific heat of chlorimeter and TC is your temperature of chlorimeter. Specific heat of chlorimeter is given 394 that as chlorimeter is made of brass. And temperature is your same that is the water is 4 degrees Celsius and MCC and mass is also mass of chlorimeter is also 128 and third one is energy of water. So MW is mass of water is 240 gram and specific water is just 4.2 kilojoule per kilogram per Kelvin and temperature of water is also same that is 4 degrees Celsius. So this is the initial energy and this initial energy the unknown thing is your CPM. And finally they settle down at 21.5 degrees Celsius. So final temperature is same for all and these values are known except the CPM. Okay. So we can put these values and we can find out this CPM. So CPM will be, so rest of all these calculations. Okay. The CPM will be 19.9 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius. Or nearest option is option 1. So we have to solve this typical calculation. Okay. To reach the nearest option, because the options are too far, you can reach the nearest option to answer 1. Okay.